Welcome to Radio Graham. Yesterday the Weather Bureau forecast a cold and wet day for Anzac Day in Canberra, so I went to the Australian War Memorial yesterday.
That's the entrance to the museum galleries. There's a free guided tour leaving here in a moment or two.
And it looks really cool.
I won't bite. I only take little nibbles, but it's okay. That's okay. Okay. So this is called Bully Beef. That's what it was nicknamed. And this is what the soldiers were given to eat. So all of these things are here in the First World War Country. Now, has Mum ever cooked you the same meal 20 times in a row? Yep, and she really sick of it. Can you imagine being given the same thing? What happened when new food came? How do you think the turkey was done? They were so excited because it wasn't what they'd been eating for months. So what they did is they opened it, and they could see it was already opened a little bit. So one of the Turkish soldiers tried it, and he thought it was the most beautiful thing he had ever tasted.
Started what we refer to as the desert campaign, conducting an advance through the eastern Palestine up through to Damascus.
Were you in Palestine right until the end?
Yes, I'll tell you where. We got as far as Damascus, you see, and that's where the Turks found that it was useless. And the promise had been made from the warlord that the Arab was to come in from Baghdad and seize Damascus, and that was their payment. For giving secret information all the time to our army. See, we had several Australians on the secret crowd. They used to ride behind the lines and all they dressed as Arabs. He was a key man, Lawrence of Arabia. And the fellow I went to school with was his pilot, his offsider, a fellow named Harper. I went to school with him. I can remember what the great general, the man that won the war there, of course.
Allenby?
Yes, of course. He was an old bugger, but he'd take me head up to him. He won the war.
Did he?
He'd come and had a look, we was doing no good. General Murray was living in Cairo, and we were losing too many men, and we wasn't strong enough to stop him. And he come and had a look, and he dismounted about 1,500 yeomanry and gave their horses to the Camel Corps, and gave the Camel Corps, which was Australians, put them on to take food and weapons and that. And where there was one artillery piece, he put about 15 or 20, and then when he did hit, only hit for about 4 days, that's when Beersheba fell.
Surviving. Damn you to hell!
No.